Govinda, 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 Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Well, it's a complete honor to be here for so many reasons that you already know. I'm very, very, very happy to see so many people in the audience, such so many great, great old friends and new friends, and everybody coming out for the dual purpose of supporting Seva. I should say the triple purpose, supporting Seva Foundation, which is just the best. Celebrating, slightly delayed, celebrating Wavy Gravy's birthday. You know, I was trying to remember when I first met Wavy, and we were just talking backstage, and it was 1971. That's a long time ago. And it's just a great honor to know him. And the third reason that I'm so happy to see so many people here is to celebrate God's name. You know, as we all know, as everybody knows, music is simply wonderful, and heartful musicians are, you know, it's a blessing on this earth, I think. But then when we combine that with these ancient names from ancient times that were given to us to uplift our hearts, to transform our hearts, to bring healing, to bring salvation to all of us, to all the universes. And what a joy that we're singing it with 1,000 people. I'm so happy to see you all here. I will introduce my band members after the next song. And I want to just remind you all that this, although we could call this a concert, it's not a traditional concert where you sit and watch us do this. I beg you and I beseech you and I invite you and I urge you all to sing with us. We do a call and response where I sing a line and you all sing the line back. And kirtan is great to just be a spectator, but it's even greater if you join in. So please do. The next song is called Queen of Hearts, and it's an invocation, a celebration of Radharani. Radha is one of the manifestations of the goddess, of the Divine Mother. But she, Radha, in this song, instead of saying Radha, we say Radhe. And Radhe is the complete embodiment, incarnation of all the colors of love, of devotion. Not just like, I am, you are, thou art great and I am pitiful. But more like, you are everything I want and I'm going to get you no matter what. So you better watch out, God. So Radha dances every dance of love. So the words of this song are Radhe, Radhe, Shyam. Shyam, S-H-Y-A-M, is one of the names of Krishna. That means the dark one, the mysterious one, the one that you can't see unless he wants you to see him or unless Radha opens the door. So that's the whole words. Radhe, Radhe, Shyam, Radhe, Radhe, Shyam. Oh, bolo means sing. Radhe, Radhe, Shyam, bolo. Radhe, Radhe, Shyam, 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 Radhe, Radhe, and different different combinations. Shyam. Let me introduce to you the act you've known for all these years. No, let me introduce to you the beautiful, beautiful tribe of friends I got on stage. Some of them you already know. So I'll start from that corner where it was your old friend, C.C. White. And I know you enjoyed C.C.'s set as much as I did. And more than that, you know, I think, this is just a supposition, it's not a fact. I think that up there, when we're all singing together good, not just us, but when we're all singing together, those invisible ones are listening and applauding. And like, I want to make them happy, because I know if I'm making them happy, they're going to make me happy. Well, wait a second. It's not a business deal. I got to take it back. I am so completely self-centered. But CeCe's awesome. Next door to CeCe is my dear, dear friend, Sandy Cressman. Now, Sandy and her husband, Jeff, used to be part of my band back in the 1940s, the Pagan Love Orchestra. So, you were an infant. I was already old. So, and next to Sandy is Pragnia Vieira. Beautiful, beautiful singer. Behind them, well, you already know from CeCe sets, but I gotta reintroduce you. Denise Kaufman. I gotta say, it was like I don't know how many years ago, after I put out my first CD, I was performing around and trying to figure out what to do. And Denise, who I didn't know, called me up and said, "I love your music, we gotta figure out a way to sell it." And here we are, there's CDs for sale. Behind me is my partner in recording for many, many years, Ben Lineback. And behind me on this side, we couldn't make it like so that the guys are one side and the girls are on this side. So we had to shift it up a little bit. And you also met Amy from CeCe set, brilliant Amy Molinelli. Yeah. And last but definitely not least, my friend, my maestro, my music teacher, and my buddy, Jose Neto. Going down to ground level. Parking garage. We're going to sing a chant to Lord Shiva. But it's not just Shiva, because the words of this chant say that the true Shiva, the true primordial, ancient, vast Lord Shiva, is never, ever, not for one moment, away from the goddess. He's always worshiping the goddess. And the words are Samba, Sada, Shiva. It's really simple. Sada means true, primordial. Shiva is the Lord of destruction, the Lord of transformation, the protector of all the devotees. And Samba means with Amba, with the mother. He's always with the mother, or else he's not the true primordial Shiva.
Shiva, Namah Shiva. Namah Shivaya.
Namah Shivaya. Namah Shivaya. Oh, Namah Shivaya. Namah Shivaya. Hara Hara Gauri. Samba Sada. See you guys dancing out there. It's so nice.
Technically, it's not allowed.
But I don't know, since when did anybody here care about that? What did you say, dear? Well, that is really cool. You want to sell it? So, you know, the songs that we sing in kirtan have many levels of meaning. I don't think in one lifetime you can plumb all the many subtleties of these words that we sing. There's thousands of books written for every single one of these words. And, you know, we're just personalizing it and taking the meanings into our heart and expressing the feelings in our souls that we don't often get to express. Sometimes I think, though, that the meaning of all the words that we sing in kirtan can just be shrunk down to one simple English word, which is just help, help me, please, Lord, help me. I cannot do it. I mean, you know, like I wake up in the morning, I don't know what to do. All through the day, I'm lost, and then I go to bed praying for help. So. Sometimes that's what I think. We can translate all this. This is Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Actually, before we sing it, I want to tell you what those words mean. Help. No. No, but it's a little bit more than that, and it's worth just paying attention for a second. Hare is the name of the goddess, the name of Radha, the name of the divine light. Krishna is the name of God, that one who permeates all existence. So when we sing Hare Krishna, we're talking about that moment when God and goddess, when soul and great soul, when husband and wife, when boyfriend and girlfriend, or boyfriend and boyfriend, or girlfriend and girlfriend, when they're completely together in absolute blissful union. So we sing Hare Krishna, then suddenly we say Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, and they're separated. The God and goddess are separated. Our soul and the universal soul is separated. Our heart and the heart of our beloveds. We're separated and we're in that anguish of separation. We all know it. We all know that feeling. And then we go, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, and God and goddess are united again. Soul and parasoul, love and love, united, one. There's no separation. There can never be separation. There's never been separation until suddenly, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, and we're separated again. And this mantra evokes that constant cycle of connection, disconnection, connection, disconnection. And in the life of the bhakta, the devotee, the person who follows the path of the heart, that painful separation is revered, is worshipped, is appreciated even greater than the moments of connection. Because it's in those painful moments of disconnection that our longing flames higher, the light in our heart flames brighter and brighter, and it says to God, help, help, help!
Hey, this just in. Karen, her water broke. Karen and Simon are having a baby tonight after the show, and they're naming the baby Jai.
Oh, that's so cool. May he have an awesome life.